They're gonna lift.
In the wild, 10 years old is pretty good life for a koala.
In zoos, you can make that up to about 50, just because if there's no predators, they can usually get the best leaves. But health checkups weekly, that sort of thing. So in zoos, you can usually make that a little bit longer. Having a bit of a scratch here. So on the back, their claws are actually really, really special. They specialise for what they need. So having a bit of a scratch there. On their back foot, two of their digits are actually fused together. So that's actually their special grooming claw that they use specifically just to claw away any extra fur. On their front hands, they've actually got two thumbs. So unlike us, they have four digits and one thumb. These guys, they have three digits and two thumbs. Yeah. So koalas, they live high up in the tree. The thumb is the strongest finger. Having two of them makes them extra strong. So they can hike that really, really good grip on the tree. So that way they won't have to slip and fall, but they fall down to the ground. So yeah, koalas spend all of their life up in the trees. This is where all of their food is as well. And they don't want to actually come to the ground. And sometimes that would get too dangerous. So dogs, foxes, dingoes, even wombats can probably give them a bit of a go. So they do prefer to stay up in the trees at night. So koalas, they are marsupials, like any animal that has a pouch. So we've got our kangaroos, our possums, our wallabies, quarroos, gliders. Most of our Australian mammals are actually marsupials. And so what that means is mum will give birth to a little joey. The joey will be really tiny, pink, will be deaf, will be blind, and have no fur. She'll give birth out of her cloaca. Then she'll lick the centra from her cloaca all the way up to the special part of her belly called the pouch. And that's where the joey will use that really, really strong sense of smell, even at that age, follow that centra up. Here it'll suckle on one finger, and another substance you can use is called pack. What pack it is, it's essentially a concentrated form of the feces. So sometimes when they can move those, they may not have to make a bit of a tumor there, because it is really vital that they get that bacteria at that early age. Later on in life, these feces are really, really hard to digest. They are that bit toxic, and they have a really tough cell wall. So having that bacteria at that early, early age allows them to develop that gut flora and that gut ability to digest their food. So they'll stay in the pack for about 6 months, and then afterwards they'll fall out. Yeah, probably. Our biggest thing is education. So doing this every day, letting people know, getting their message out there. We trade koalas with other zoos, so that way we have a good breeding captive breeding population. Keep that going. So we swap our males with other zoos in the area every year to try and get them. Totally miss that. Most important thing, really. So these guys, they sleep for about 20 hours together. And the reason for that is, well, there's not that much energy actually really using it.
Hold it.